Alright, sup guys, this is MoFoCThat, and today this is going to be a bit of a combo video today. So, I have two pieces of artwork from Krazil. This is Soundwave and Deadpool, respectively, and it's just something really nice that I'm probably going to hang up on my wall somewhere. Tape. I wanna staple these guys somewhere I can't take it off. It's very nice. So, main part of this video is the Gunpla Navigation Catalog 012, which is the reason I'm doing this because, well, it's more informative, I have more information, plus I did last year's too, when I went to Anime Expo 2011. So here's both of them, full cycle frame, destroy modes, Banshee and Unicorn. Very nice cover. And right here, just like last time, it's scales and then the table of contents right here. So, right here, you can see the little chibi SD-like figure right here. And both of these are 1/144th scale. And here is the high grade, which is what I collect mostly because they're affordable. And here's the real grade version, which you can see is more detailed and more anime accurate. You can see here this color variation, plus there's more sticker detail. And here is the master grade, the 1/100 scale, which is so much taller. And it's very nice looking. And here, oh, it's the perfect grade. It's just fantastic. Fantastic. Looks awesome, but it's always too pricey for me. And here, table of contents, you can see the What is Gunpla? And here is the Gunpla HQ in Japan. Right here is How to Make Gunpla. Tells you right here, before assembly. Cut out the pots, assembling. Attaching, finish strike pose, and then you can always put in detail. And down here, this is where Gunpla shines, that part right there. Here's this easy snap fit. So it tells us before they used to make, in the older kits, you had to glue them together. And here is point two, the Aeropla. Just basically the multi-color moding for the same runners. See here, the red, yellow, and the black, so you don't have to paint it. Here's the touch gate. These are for the, I think these were for the higher price scales, like the master, the perfect grade, or the master, the newer ones, because it's a touch gate, and you can just, whoosh. And here's the, yeah, this is by hand, so you can just pull it out instead of clipping them out. And here's the undergate, which some of these utilize. You can see it in the Unicorn for some of the outer armor parts, and here is the multi-insert castings modes parts so they can fit together and easily assembled. So this is basically kind of like the weapons and like the arms, like you cut off one half, just attach the other half and cut that out and just assemble. So let's turn over, and here is like a sort of timeline. Just 1980, the original Gundam, not the, the original kit for the RX-78, and here is, you can see how it's progressed over time into the real grade. And here, this talks about the Gundam Age story. You can see here, here's the Gundam Age right here. Here is the main character of each age anime, which is related. There's Gundam Age 1 anime Flit, and then Age 2 Osamu, and Age 3 Kyo. So, in Age 3 be grandfather, father, and then the main character, aka the son. And, and over here is just a main summary of each series. And over here you can see the age model kits. You see here age 1 Nomo, age 1 Swallow, and the age 1 Titus. See how each one progresses over time. See here are the Geno Aces, which I love. I love the freaking Geno Aces. And here are these Gundams right here, which I always thought as the Power Rangers of the age line, to be quite honest. It's hilarious. Here's the SD Gundam and the Master Grades and the Mega Size model. I didn't know that these came out yet, Mega Size models. And here is the summaries of the 5 episodes that have come out. Here is Gundam Unicorn. See the Black Unicorn. And here, right here, is the suits of each one. So here goes into the Master Grades first with Unicorn with the MS Cage. Sinaju, the Rezo Commander, Delta Plus Unicorn version Katoshi, which is the full armor right here. Here's the Banshee. And the Rezo and the Unicorn Gundam in HD color. Then down on this side, this is all of the high grades, which is here's the Destroy Mode, and here's the Unicorn Mode, which I own right here. Then the Rezel, Stark Jigan, the Loto Twin Set, Delta Plus, Jigan, Jason, just the Z Zulu, the Banshee Destroy Mode. I have this, but in the exclusive Anime Expo version. And here's the base Unicorn Mode, the Delta Gundam, which I love. I love this. And here's the Anksha, which is a very interesting Gundam. Here's the base Jabber and Nemo. And here's the SD Gundams. And it's interesting because even though this is so damn small and fragile, I can still transform from Unicorn to Destroy Mode. And here is Gundam Seed. And as you know, they're celebrating the 10th anniversary. It's very nice. And here it tells you the story. And here is the Master Grade, High Grade, Perfect Grade, and SD Grade. See the Allele Strike Gundam, Strike Rouge, Dual Gundam, I love this one. The Buster Gundam, which is gonna release in September. Ooh, that's an interesting, because this is an interesting suit. And plus, I'm gonna be reviewing the no grade in a few videos, so very nice. See the real grade, it already has Leo Strike Gundam, the Justice Gundam. I believe the last Seed Gundam I had, excluding the no scale, no grade, Strike dagger, it would have been... It was either the high-grade Justice or the high-grade Infinite Justice one. Here's the Astray Red Frame, Blue Frame. Nice. The dual Gundam right here, Buster Gundam again. Renewed. Now some of these are renewed, oh that's quite nice. Calamity Gundam, Forbidden Gundam, and the Raider Gundam, which is... I'm not sure about this one, I can't remember this one, but I know these two for sure is one of the... two of the three suits that were stolen by Zaft in the beginning of the series. And here's Providence Gundam, Justice Gundam. Actually, looking at this, I probably got the Infinite Gundam one. There's the Mark 1 Astray, Strike Gundam, Gundam Astray again. Here's the SD or versions of it. This is a two-page ad about the real grade. See here, the new inner frame right here. It's very nice. And tell us here, the perfect combination that of features from high grade, master grade, and perfect grade. Just the inner frame is constructed of only 12 parts, which is very, very nice. A new balance of build and capability. So, these would be like mass perfect grade detail, but with high grade posability and playability, so you can actually play with these as a toy. Nothing beats the world grade again. The Strike Freedom, and here's what came out for it: the original RX-78, two Gundam, Char Zaku 2 in green, Freedom Gundam, Sky Grasper Gundam Mark 2, Gundam Mark 2, the Justice Gundam. Oh, this looks pretty nice. Here's the high grade 144th scale. Build your collections. Collect by first series model, new models out following the anime. Elio Strike, Freedom Gundam, and Mark 1 Stray from the renewed Gundam C. Master Grade, 1/100 scale. Loaded with animation style gimmicks. Very nice. Double jointed. Off the charts playability. Full armor options. It's nice that they showed the Assault Shroud for the dual Gundam. Well, it shows off the Zakus again. The inner mechanics. This looks very nice. And here is the Master Grade. All of them. So you have the GM, Ball, RX-72, Gun Tank, Gun Cannon, the Dom, the ZONG. Oh, the Shiaku Shinki plus Balut system. This is another one that I love. The Haiku Shinki regular. The Double Zeta Gundam. The new Gundam. It's nice. I have the SD figure down there. The Sazabi. Which I also have an SD figure down there too. The Gundam Unicorn. Tsunaju. Delta Plus. Banshee. Full armor unicorn version to Katoshi, Shining Gundam, Gundam Death Scythe, Wing Gundam, Master Gundam, Turn A Gundam, Gundam Astray, Dual Gundam, Blitz Gundam, Blaster Gundam. Here shows you the perfect grade, 160 scale. Here shows you all the nice features. Here's the Zeta Gundam, Sky Grasper. Very nice, it shows you the inner mechanics of the Strike Ruse and Gundam Mark II. The Zeta Gundam shows you the transformation bit of it, which is very nice. Here, the whole new world of Gunpla. This is the SD version. which is very nice, because you can... This is kind of like the Metabots of the Gundam world, because you can always mix and match parts. Well, technically in any skill you can mix and match parts, but... If I remember correctly, I think these are a bit bigger than the what do you call them? The Betamon? The... Betamon? I think that was the name of it. Betamon. It was like a combination of like those marble shooters and like those mini statues. You can have them and you can shoot out marbles from their chest. There's a game off of that. There's an anime series out of that. I still don't understand why certain things get anime. There is the mega size model, the 1/48th scale. Jaw dropping size, not large show texture. This is actual fucking. So the Gundam Age normal would come in December, while Gundam Age 2 will release in March. So it's already. So this one has already been released, and so has this one. These are only for the mega size. For the 0.1, you can just pull a lap. 0.2, snap fit. 0.3. In collaboration with... Also, like, Denki Hobby and Hobby Japan. It also has tips and tricks, like which markers to use, like the fine point or the bland for panel lining on certain figures. And here's fun sprue-lock assembly. Like arms and leg, double separator, which is easier than the clippers. Color and illustrated manual. So if you, so it's kind of be like nose grade kits, cause they're all in color. So it'd be like that. So it looks cool without painting. And then there, here's decals or. Decal, depending on how, on what part of the world you're in. And here is the rest of the, BB series. The SD gun, and here's transformable unicorn gun. And here is the Gundam Age series we can. The switch out part, so if you buy like three of each, you can always change them to the separate parts, because you don't have enough parts to make all three in one kit. You have to change out parts. And here's the history of timeline. The history slash timeline, because it shows you what shit goes where. So here's the original series, the G Gundam, Zeta Gundam, Victory Gundam, Double Zeta. And here's the movies. And more until now. It's very nice. Whoosh. So many Gundam anime have come out the past years. Here's the Devotion. Gunpla. It shows the R&D department, design, prototyping, laser processing, and then the mode machine processing, mode finishing, production, compile, production, injection molding. And here is the new thing that's been around for a bit, the Gundam.info site. Basically the official thing for like the anime products, events, like